Hey guys, it's me again. So basically, first off, that music in there, I don't know if you can hear it, but it's my mom practicing. She is a musician and we're getting ready for a concert soon and everything. So yeah, basically just wanted to explain that. Secondly, the reason I did not make a video yesterday, I got in trouble and my mom wouldn't let me. So yeah, part of being a 15-year-old. Thirdly, I am making a video today because I don't want to make you guys wait till next Tuesday, to know what the heck is going on. Yeah, basically. So, today's video is, as you can probably tell by the title, why not to be boy crazy. So, basically, I'm just gonna talk about this for a little while because I feel like it's kind of a big issue with girls, like teenage girls and stuff. And for those of you who are younger than me, this could help. And also people who are older than me, because maybe I figured this out before some of you guys did. By the way, just saying, do not judge the fact that I am wearing a giant hoodie, because I'm a teenage girl and I like giant hoodies. This is actually my dad's, because I don't have, like, I've never had a boyfriend, so I don't have, like, boyfriend clothes. So I have my dad's clothes, and I don't care if you think that's weird. So, yeah. Okay. I was getting a little off topic there. Yeah, but I just wanted to say that. So, let's move on. Okay, so, going to basically list some reasons why it's not good to be boy crazy. Guys do not like you that much when you're boy crazy. Basically, they, like, they're, I mean, I know you've probably heard this, like, a gazillion times in other places, but seriously, though, I mean, so, when I was 10, I was, this is just proof, when I was 10, I was absolutely boy, like, insanely boy crazy, and, like, and so I had all these crushes. I had a list of crushes in my diary. I still have it now in my diary and everything. From when I was 10, I had this whole list of crushes, and they were all just like, pretty much every boy I knew was on my crush list. I was just like, if he's a boy and he's breathing, I like him. So yeah, they don't go for that. I ended up, I had like, two different major crushes who I was obsessed with, and I had them on my crush list, and I always, at all times, I had my number one crush. This one guy was my number one crush for, like, 3 years. This other guy was my number one crush for, like, 2 years. And then I had all my little minor crushes under that. So, I have experience in being boy crazy. Like, do not, go... Like, oh, you just don't like guys that much. Because, like, yeah, this is not a thing I can't relate to. So, there. Yeah, I ended up traumatizing this guy for life. I still feel bad about it. He's like, I mean, he was 15 when I started liking him. And I was 12. And I really thought I had a chance with him. Yeah, besides the fact that he was, like, scared to death of girls already, and I just made that worse by stalking him for 3 years. He's 18 now. Actually, I didn't stalk him for 3 years. It was only two. But he's 18 now, and I think he's dating someone, so that's good. Like, I'm glad I didn't totally traumatize him. I'm getting off topic. Basically, yeah, it scares them to death. Like, they don't want to be around you. I didn't have anybody that liked me when I was 10. I wasn't friends with guys at all. I didn't start being friends with guys. My first guy friend I had was, like, a year ago. First guy friend ever. Guys were scared of me before that. Okay. More, like, and the flip side of that is my little sister, who is 10 now. And I feel old because my little sister is 10. I mean, I remember when she was born and she's like 10 now. I'm just like, that was a decade ago. I mean, it's one thing to be alive for a decade. I was like, I've been alive for like a decade. Yeah. But now I have a little sister who's been alive for a decade, who's 5 years younger than me. So yeah, what I was saying is that she, has guys all over her all the time. Like, she's totally different than me. She's more of a tomboy kind of and everything. And so she literally goes around and all of the little boys just like all over her, and she hates it. There's this one kid she actually likes at our synagogue, and that's it. She doesn't like any of the rest of them. She thinks all the rest of them are, like, annoying as crap. Like, and, yes, so, just, that is proof. So, that was number one. They don't go for it. This is totally random, but does my hair look okay? Like, it's driving me crazy, and it's kind of oily. Okay, I need to stop. Sorry. Random thing. Glasses? Or no? Just comment, because I'm really not sure if the nerd glasses work with this hair, and I really like my nerd glasses. But yeah, anyway, okay. New reason not to be boy crazy. One second. This right here. This is the reason. No, I mean, it's not just the reason, but if you're boy crazy, chances are you will write it down somewhere. All your, like, boy crazy frustration. And, like, you will... I mean, maybe you won't keep diaries. This is the last 5 years of my boy crazy life. Or I guess four. This was basically, like, heartbreak. This was boy craziness. All of it. That's, like, I mean, that's a lot. And I still have all of this to look back at and like just cringe at how much of an idiot I was. Like, hold on, just a second. Example. So like in this entry in my third diary, I was sitting there like, I miss him already. And I just saw him yesterday. Like, I don't know if I can take this anymore. I'm not gonna read you a bunch of examples, but I was pathetic. So yeah. Reason number two. This. All these. I mean, yeah. I was an idiot. Got all of this to prove it! It's just, it's not... I mean, yeah, it's kind of funny to look back on sometimes, but it's really embarrassing sometimes to admit that you were really that much of a stalker when you were younger. Reason number three. This is the last reason. Now, I mean, I could come up with like 10 more, but I'm just trying to boil it down. So maybe you get this through your head, maybe. And it might help you. I'm hoping maybe it'll help someone. Or maybe you can just watch it and laugh at me. I don't know. Maybe it's just entertainment. I don't really care. I mean, I hope it helps someone. But yeah, we'll just see what happens. And yeah, so... Just recording that whole time? Ah, crap, I'm screwed. I'm really that whole time. I don't know if I can fix that or not. I might be able to. I'll just watch it later and forget. Okay. I'm not sure if I, what exactly I was saying before. I mean, I know the basic thing. Basically, if you spend your entire teenage life obsessing over guys, you will look back later and go, like, that sucked. Like, why did I do that? Like, I just wasted my whole teenage life, or I could have been doing other things that were, like, fun, and thinking about, like, what I was gonna be when I was gonna grow up and everything, and, like, spending time with my friends, and, well, I mean, I'm assuming you actually have friends. I don't, but, I mean, I have friends, but I don't have, like, friends who are, like, in my town. Like, I have no social life. I have like a phone life. Oh my god, my phone life is fantastic. I talk on the phone, text people all the time. It's just that there's nobody here, like, who spends time with me. But maybe that'll change. I hope so. Anyway, sorry for getting off on all that. Basically, yeah. So just keep in mind, it just really, you will not regret it once you if you like start getting yourself not obsessed with guys, if you start kind of getting away from that and like cutting off those ties and stuff, you will feel like amazing. Like, I mean, really recently I finally got over this last guy I had a huge crush on, and it was the first time literally in 5 years that I hadn't had some, like, emotional attachment to another guy. And it's really cool. Once you get there, and you're just like, wait a second. I can, like, think about other things, and I'm just not constantly, my mind, like, taken up with this guy. Like, it's kind of freaking awesome. So, yeah. Anyway, this video is, like, almost 13 minutes long now. And I'm gonna go ahead and shut up. I just want to let you guys know, I will not be posting a video on Friday because I'm going to a youth conference thing with my youth group. And my aunt is coming on Saturday, but she's leaving on Tuesday. So next week will be back to normal. This week, I'm not gonna be able to post a cover. Now, I might be able to post a video of a song I'm doing with my mom at this concert we're doing. Other than that, I'm not sure. So yeah, that might be up, and if it is up, it'll be up on either Saturday or Sunday. But I will definitely start back. I'll talk about something else next Tuesday, and then I will post some to cover next Friday, and things will be back to normal. So yeah. Would like to contribute to what I talk about on my videos, please just comment suggestions below. Just random topics that you want to hear my opinion on, or just stuff. Just if you have anything that pops in your head you want me to talk about, just comment below, and I will do it at some point. I'll add it to my list of ideas for things to talk about in my future videos, and I will give you credit if I use yours in the caption or whatever it's called. Comment and subscribe. And if you want to keep like track of my videos and keep watching and stuff. And I love you all. So, bye.